permanent for Fridays.
Until the foreseeable future.
Hey, yo! Is that the robot?
Operating Buddy?
Is that Robert's Operating Buddy?
Robert?
Using the blood red rod, love to see it.
I think it's one of his best ones. I think it's one of his best, for sure.
He has a camo one. I like the yellow rod personally, but yellow's my favorite color, so I'm fine.
Green is my favorite, but I think the red one just looks... I think black and red is always a good aesthetic that you can really never go wrong with.
Of course.
At least in design.
They're just gonna put some like decals on it, put some flames on it.
That'd be sick.
You could mod that in, yeah.
Oh yeah, that's easy enough. But it would've been sick to have like stickers, just like on Rob.
That would've been cool.
I think just little nice details like that, like a little figurine. Like,
ooh. He didn't even look like he was near the ledge to get that spike, but he caught it right on the tip of it. I think Pai will definitely be a character, a player who enjoys making use of that down air. So he's got even more frames to work with when timing edge guards in that situation. Cool Guy Jones gonna try and play it reasonably slow. I don't know how many times he spot Pies with Rob, but...
I think this is only the first time. He's been only practicing within the last week.
Yeah, that's what I figured. I just didn't know if they played anything before then.
But I think it's a matter of, has he played enough Rob?
Yes.
In general. Does that like that kind of baseline knowledge?
Exactly. This will be pretty good for... Ooh! So I think you could have also gotten side B there, but...
I guess damage is damage.
You want to get damage there, not getting the kill, but like side B also gets probably off stage as well, I know. Right. Yeah, very solid jab lock conversion there from Pai. And this will also be good practice for him as well, since,
you're fine to me, Rob.
Follows in bracket overall, it's going to be reasonably common, so, yeah. No, I agree with that. There's not many Robs other than Suplex, and that's a very meta matchup, so it'll be good to have more practice with that.
First and foremost, break he spelled it. He spelled it wrong.
He said break it. Everyone laugh at him. Hold on. Right.
Giggle.
Omega. It's okay. It's okay that I spelled that wrong because it's not active anyway.
Yeah, but I can grab you the link real quick.
Oh, yeah. I guess somebody should help.
I was wondering why I couldn't just right click.
Oh yeah. Yeah. Even game here.
Oh yeah, it even up really nicely while we were distracted. Cool and cool guy getting the up air there. Mm-hmm. See out the stock.
I think this is definitely the one thing I'm noticing, like Pai knows what options to pick, but he's just the character's not in his hands yet, and so like once he's just moving very, very purposefully with Rob, knowing it's that idiomatic component of your character where you're just kind of moving as fast as the character's capable. You know, Pai's choosing the right options, but just trying to take it at a pace that he can keep up with, but once he gets used to it, you're gonna see some Rob movement, I'm sure. Ooh, going for the spike there.
Oh but he couldn't
recover.
No.
That's so tragic.
That's very, very unfortunate.
I'll remember this when I go to back to Kansas. Just remember that it was it was Beast Mike. Alright, so game two. Gonna be real with you. That was a heartbreaker. But I guess if there was one if there's one match you want that to happen in, it's the first game of a best of five, so.
Right.
We'll see if Cool Guy Jones can shake that off and solidly take the next game. But if you're Pai in the meantime, you'll absolutely take those.
Absolutely.
Your Rob's getting some solid wins out here. Ooh, he made that up just now and it worked out.
Yo, Beast Man? Yeah, that's me, baby.
Ooh,
I got my
guess
Among
the
Us bracelet.
Approaching fair. Tries to get the jump read, not gonna quite happen there. Yeah, I can even see he's running off the platform with Bear, but he's not comfortable with that timing yet. Bear's still being very slow, but you wanna click it as early as you can because it's a pretty slow move to come out. Oh, not the best air dodge, but Cool Guy Jones gonna eat that for breakfast.
Nom nom nom.
Boom.
Just
yeah. I'm actually a huge fan of the no mash as well, but didn't work out there for it.
Yeah, no mash is a personal favorite of mine, but you know, at some point it's just not gonna work. Yeah. You just get another kill off.
Exactly.
We're seeing some mash pressure with Nair from Cool Bad Guys. He's just going at it.
Are we hearing Bubblegum KK right now on PS2?
I don't think so.
Maybe I'm hearing it on another setup or something.
I think you are.
Okay. Because I'm like, that doesn't make any sense. Oh, did you see that? He got like a no-impact land on the platform with Rob. That was kind of funny. Uh-oh.
Oh.
Oh.
No.
Yeah, I think he wasn't sure how far the fair sent him, so he tried to go for the...
like an instant recovery.
Exactly.
Unfortunate.
Rob's usually fine here.
Yeah. I find it's just, in some cases, just best not to interact with Rob offstage.
You know, there's definitely a mix-up to be played. Most of the time you shouldn't, but you should not let Rob, if Rob's not expecting it,
right.
It sometimes it just takes one hit.
And it ruins their game plan. But
exactly, but yes.
They just have the, oh shit! Hit him with the
combos. Cool Guy Jones can get sexy with follows sometimes. Especially when you're down. You gotta come up with something. Yeah, Pi playing the very safe Rob game plan here. Very effective stuff. Oop, shoots the gyro the wrong way. His back is facing the stage, too.
Do you know if you can reverse that?
Not in any way that's not like a specific B reverse. You have to either B reverse or reverse special, I think.
Because that might have been what he was going for, but...
He might have been trying to, yeah, B reverse the gyro. But you notice how it didn't matter, because he's Rob.
He just makes it back because...
He made it back. They might as well just skip all of the wherewithal. Just put Rob at center stage. A true teleport. Just boop in one frame. But yeah, Cool Guy Jones keeping his head on his shoulders here, but Pi making a lot of use of his stock by staying alive.
Ooh, down with the...
He's really good at hitting just the edge of that up air. Oh no! The side B partially connected to
Cool. And he got that one hit in there.
Oh yeah!
Up a whole string. It's crazy.
Some people say, yeah, I personally don't believe that myth. I mean, they also say that you can just look at the side of Rob's body, but I can't see anything. I don't know what they mean. Yeah, but Cool Guy Jones coming back here.
Do you see that blue gauge on the side?
Where?
You'll see it eventually.
No, I know. I was being ironic, unless you just reverse irony in me, which HTVs. Oh my god, the pressure. See now, Cool Guy Jones, very, very solid player in situations like this, but you know he should have gone for the dare.
Yeah.
Oh no.
That was kind of stinky for a second there. Maybe not
that
the best.
That was so unfortunate.
Maybe not the...
But if he hits you out the other side, you have the worst DI possible.
Yes, you are
so it's
gonna
like,
die.
And you can't see what direction Rob's facing when he's down there, so... Yeah. I think, once again, very close game, but Kai stayed alive so long in second stock that he was able to get so much decent percent off. Yeah, what a statement, though, if he's able to take this set 3-0 with Rob. But Cool Guy Jones definitely gonna try and see if he can. He's been getting had, shall we say, in some of these last interactions.
Because I do believe possibly that if he didn't SD those two thoughts, he might be up 2-0
instead. Which
is a very possible toss-up.
Isn't that messed up? People joke about the whole 3-0 close though thing, but like their games are so swingy, you know.
It's just insane sometimes.
Oh, try to use the rotor arms to either stall or reflect side beam.
A little too high for it, but oh.
See, and in those situations, if you hit Rob once, that's when you want to go after him because he's low on gas. So you want to actually like pressure him. Even just pressuring him by making it look like you're going to do something forces the Rob to act in a situation he normally wouldn't have to.
Oof.
Didn't that look like such a brutal slam? Boom! I don't know, maybe something about Rob's body contorting.
I think it was something personal.
It wasn't even into anything, just slams into the ground. I saw a smash attack about to come out. Yeah.
I think it was up smash.
Yep.
A Cool Guy Jones classic.
That is the Cool Guy Jones right there. The scoop. Yeah, he tried to grab Gyro and got punished for it, unfortunately.
Sometimes, man, that Gyro just does everything.
It really does. Pi's been playing it. He's been playing it very, very solid and disadvantage, and I think that's been pretty frustrating to deal with if you're Cool Guy Jones. Because Rob is a character where, like, you have to be landing the kills on him, and his weight makes it so that Paulo has to at least try a little bit harder to kill in those scenarios. But I think the difference maker is in those edge guards, it's in those offstage situations where Paulo has a pretty solid kill shot on overall, which you can take advantage of. But you see that? Pi just drifted right around the side B.
And, the stage
ate it.
Yeah.
That happens sometimes when you go for it and it just doesn't connect. Yep. But gonna connect with that one there.
Up two stocks.
Up two stocks, yeah.
You're going extremely well.
I'll go ahead and say it, because I think Cool Guy Jones has got this. No, I'm not gonna say it, it's Rob. I was gonna say there was no way he could possibly lose this one, but Oh god, he caught the jump of the Gyro too. The dash back. Yeah, this is. And now that I think about it, if Pi makes this last stop really, really last in terms of. There it is!
Hit him with it.
Hit
baby.
That man's with the I Like Pi enough. Excellent game tape from Cool Guy Jones. Could be the momentum shift that he needed, but.
If he wants to pull a true Cool Guy.
Who just yelled? I wasn't paying attention.
There's someone back there. Probably C.
So, both characters have a lot to work with here. I think what this will mean is that if either of them get hit off stage, they're probably gonna die at those mid percents.
Ooh, that jab could have been bad.
It could have been pretty bad. I think neither of them were worried too much, but
it just would have been a lot of damage because he was just kind of stuck in a really
bad
spot.
When you're stuck at the edge like that, you have no options other than to eat that. I wish there was a skip button. It's like how I feel with Inkling Jab. Like, they just have you in the corner and say, all right, you got me. You got me with your free jab.
Free funny, haha funny, can I not now?
Yeah. Goes for the parry dash attack in the back air. Very solid stuff.
Very clean. Ooh.
That's what happens to me when I mash too. No!
He got 8% though. That's mad damage.
Rob is carried. All he had to do was down throw and nothing else. And it killed his opponent.
He's too good.
Truly crazy.
Truly the mind games of Rob down throw are too powerful.
Definitely too powerful for the buffer system. But Cool Guy Jones getting a good string here. He's starting to move a little bit. He had to hold it for that much longer. Okay, here's what I will say. The messed up part about that move is that it can also shield poke. But I think that was dangerous regardless because the platforms were just about to move. Unless Cool Guy Jones went for an immediate, like, out of shield, like, grab or something that could punish that, it would have been dangerous to be up there regardless for either of them, so. Both of them are glad to be alive right now. Ooh, good gyro placement there. First one there in. Why didn't give it to him? Ooh, that down tilt. Yeah.
Wasn't ready for it.
Rob is a bear that can challenge even Paulo sometimes.
He's getting a lot of mileage out of that gyro.
Yeah, I can tell one of the things that Pi has been practicing first with this character has been disadvantage. Like, making sure to land the gyro just close enough to where it stops runoff options. It makes your opponent less comfortable at the ledge trying to edge guard, as well as mixing up his own recovery. So it's something that, you know, it's one of the first things people usually work with a new character. Very dangerous stuff, but I appreciate the risks. Sometimes you gotta just call Rob out. If you're not gonna stop me from doing this, I'm gonna take this damage. That was good matchup information there. That down tilt stuffing out the gyro. Catches the jump away with the nair. He he's just gotta take this kick. He can take the stock. This is hella doable. Ooh, going for the anathema special. Did you see drop the gyro in place? If your opponent rolls in, you can kill them.
Oh, that was a great catch on that forward tilt.
And they say Palu forward tilt's a bad move.
He got the ball. So he got him.
And we are in a game set 5 situation.
Very turntable what could happen.
And now we have the true final boss here. And on Smash Roll as well. Watching them both nair into each other.
wait, it's close enough.
Close enough.
We take those.
Yeah, Smashville gonna favor whoever gets the hit first, I think, because the less stage one Palu gives another, the better. Yeah, Pai is very, very confident with his conversions, as is Cool Guy Jones, but we'll see. I think. Well, you have to think, right? Part of the issue with having multiple characters in a set is that you have to make sure they're all warm. And Cool Guy Jones has been fighting against Rob all day in this set. His Palu is nice and crispy now. So this is
big warm.
And he only has to win one game here, and then he's guaranteed top two here. So if you're Pai, you gotta at least spend a little few interactions, you know, getting Palu back into your hands, but. As a dedicated Palu main, I'm sure that won't take too long. Uh-oh.
Yeah. That cool guy with the classic.
See that? And in that situation, he can't really get punished too hard if he spaces the up smash to where if Pai jumps off the ledge with an option, he can still, like, he can either shield or spot dodge or get around it somehow. So. It's a really good read that not enough Palus go for, I think. What is this movement?
He's pressing.
Oh.
That looked a little...
It's tough. That wasn't a reactable dash attack.
Yeah.
He was probably, right at the moment he got hit by it, he was probably trying to run in.
Yeah.
Ooh, but catches him with the side B there. We have an even game. No jump on here for Cool Guy Jones, though. Oh, catches the jump on the ledge. Oh! The one thing in the game that can beat Palu up air under the ledge.
Palu
down air.
Of course.
Still has no jump. This is so rough. He's lost so much momentum. He took 60 after getting spiked. That's so brutal. He's gotta hang in there. He's gotta win these neutral interactions little by little. But Pai's definitely gonna put some heat on him now that he's this close to taking the set.
You'll be back.
Yep. Yep, and this is Smashville.
Yep.
Yeah, good parry. Get the F tilt after. Carry him to the corner.
Ooh,
that down tilt beat.
I mean, it's much lower than where dash attack is.
It is.
Just click their feet.
I guess I expected the dash attack to still hit first, but definitely good spacing there from Cool Guy Jones.
1-5.
Yeah, Pai, this is the same situation as before, where like Pai's just trying to get percent here. He doesn't really care about taking a stock unless he gets a good opportunity. As long as he gets good percent here, the set is all but secured unless Cool Guy Jones has some saucy as his attack to show us. Oh, there's the up air.
Oh, yep. Very close there.
Yeah, just every bit of damage matters so much. Tries to read the dash back, but Pai's gonna mix that up.
Very smart.
Yep.
He got out of there very quickly.
Yeah. And here we go again. Now, this is not over. Rage Palu can do some stuff, but can he do some stuff that Pai hasn't seen before? Is the question.
Dead. Yeah.
Excellent conversion.
Unfortunate.
Gets the drag down there into up tilt.
Still very well played from both. Cool Guys only almost pulled the reverse Pai.
Like, I just feel...
Justice.
Like, cool guy... Cool.